Good old home sweet home. Oh man, it is good to be back. Welcome back everybody to another episode of Minecraft Pocket Edition. This is Dallas. We're here on episode 136 today. Hope so. Didn't check the last episode number, I forgot. But yeah, we are finally home. As you guys know, last episode we left off out at a desert village. It was far away, so far, much farther than I thought, but I was tired of adventuring, so I finally made my way home, and we are home. Man, you would have no idea. It was awful. I actually was scared to come home because I thought that, some stuff was going to be despawned, but everything seems to be here except for one thing. Two things, really. A lot of you said Admiral's going to be here, but that didn't happen. Admiral, that would have never happened. He's probably still way out there somewhere for all we know, but, one person did despawn. It's not this guy. I thought it was him for a while. But it's Terry. Terry is gone, and I thought that was Terry walking around, but that was just one villagers have created. But yeah, Terry, our iron golem, with a name tag on him, despawned. That's Pocket Edition for you. That's like our fourth, or more than that, thing that had a name tag on him that has despawned so far. But yeah. Anyway, I want to get started on projects very soon. I've already been getting started on stuff, just like details. Some stuff might look different, actually, such as this over here. I have made a little mini display, and I love how it turned out. This is, of course, just to show our map. I like having maps all over the place. This is our main map, of course, the 3x3. I even added a little pond of water and some nether wart there. And I think I want to put a bigger map on this side, which I do have the things to do it. You know what? These right here, I guarantee these are fully grown. Yeah, how many did I get back? Two. Yeah, they are grown. I guess there's a nether rack, or not nether rack, nether thing bug, because these things fully grow, but they don't show it. Yeah, look, I got a lot back from that one. yeah, we're just going to be working around with small things around the house. I don't want to get on any projects right yet because I just got back and I don't know what to do exactly. But down here, this is what that map is, if you didn't know, that 3x3. And I think I want to put this one on the other side. Oh yeah, by the way, there's going to be a lot of lag. I've been having a lot of lag issues lately. I don't know what it is, but this is the next 3x3 one we need to do. We still haven't finished it. Still got that one, and that one, sadly. But I'm going to go ahead and copy these ones I have now and put them over there. Oh my god, this is one thing I forgot about. I forgot that you can literally copy maps from each other. You know what I mean? Make a bunch of paper, make the maps, and then you can take one map that is already created and put that in an anvil with an empty map and then just copy that map. I used to go out and explore that whole map again, and it makes me mad knowing that I did not know that. Oh gosh. It doesn't even use XP, I don't think, does it? I'm still level 30. I thought, well, why do you know? You learn something new every day, I guess. Oh, gosh. Wish I could learn sooner. Alright, there we go. Obviously not finished yet. These ones take a little bit more to explore, which I could do. I'll do that really soon, actually, because I want to get this one finished. I kind of like this center display. This will also help people, obviously, when they get my world download. But I've been trying to diagnose... I know you guys don't want to hear about lag, but I've been trying to diagnose this lag. As you guys know, last few episodes, my frame rate is perfect because I'm out in an area that doesn't have all these things and whatnot here. The only reason I get a lot of lag here is because, well, I have a lot of stuff. And a lot of you say that it's the map walls, which I do not think it is at all. Well, see, like that lag spike. I do not think it is the map walls at all, because if you did not know, they are not entities or whatever you would call them, because the devs said they made map or item frames like normal blocks. Oh god, that lag is horrible. And so these are not the problem. As you saw that big lag spike there, this was already loaded in, I believe. And what wasn't loaded in was this right back here, which is probably one of my biggest redstone machines in my world, which is this, the big behemoth brewing station. And if you know, back here there's a lot, there it was again, I don't know, there's a lot of redstone back here, and every time I come over here, this, like, that's one thing that loads up that makes me hit that. I just have bad lag spikes, like, it's just like one big freeze. I don't know what it is, but I really wish, man, he just ran off, he didn't, what the, I'm not even holding on my pickaxe. That was weird. What is going on? My thumbs are not on my screen right now. What? Stop it. I want my pickaxe. All right, let's go do something else. Alrighty, guys. So next big project on my list. This is a big one, and it's the last thing we need is another big project. One to add to the list that we still need to complete, because we have a lot of projects to complete, but it's fun to add more and more on, because then you have variety to choose from. But it's been a while since we've expanded our house, and I've been wanting to do it for a while. Oh, come on. Yeah, I've been wanting to do it for a while now. I just didn't know which way to do it, and I think I found the way I finally want to expand it. So as you can see down here, that's our fishing hut over there. This is a big open area over here that I've never knew what to do with, because there's a lot of caves and whatnot and just weird ravine stuff. But as you can see, I have a layout right here. I don't have a pillar right there, but that's our 9x9 we normally do. What I'm wanting to do is create a big courtyard in the center here and have another part of my house circle this big area, kind of like the center in this area over here, and then have another big center over here. Maybe put a giant tree in the center. That is my plan, and that's what I want to do. Not anytime soon. This might start around, probably after we finish our storage room. Let me turn this down now. Nothing. That's going to start soon. But this episode, I think I want to start working around here a bit. See our pathways here? I've mentioned this a few episodes back. I like them. They're nice, but I've been experimenting a bit. As you can see, I've been adding some cobble, some dirt, or that's not dirt, that's gravel, just to make it look like some stone everywhere. I've been adding some grass patches. It looks all right, but I don't know if I'm feeling it. It kind of looks out of place. I just don't like the big wide open pathways that I've been having. I want it to look more roughed up and whatnot. So I'm going to try to experiment with that some, and then I'll show you guys what I come up with. It might just end up being like it is now, kind of roughed up, but every pathway I have finished, because I'm just tired of seeing it like it is over here. This is freaking hard, man. I've been trying for a while, trying to make good pathways, but it feels like I lost my skill in just Minecraft in general. I don't know, like, do you guys like this? Let me know down below if you guys kind of like this pathway. It's just really hard to work with this path grass, because I know how to make really good pathways that don't involve this path grass. And that is this. Right here. Kind of like this style. I always like using gravel, cobble, mossy stone, and andesite. And those all together, even sometimes stone brick, make a really good pathway when you're not involved with this stuff. I was thinking for the longest time, maybe I should just get rid of my path grass walkways all together and just go with stone, but that, I got a feeling that would look really bad, considering it would have like a really light gray walk area and then all the rest like a of wooden and green. So I did decide not to do that. So that's why I tried to implement just a few, like, that's what random pieces like this are for, therefore. That made sense. Therefore is because it just makes it look like there's some stone around. I don't know though, guys. You just give me your input. What do you guys think? I've tried messing with it up here, just giving like a few grass pieces here and there. I'm really gonna have to work with this in between episodes because I don't know, I'm just not the best at making pathways. Over here looks nice. Another thing I realized is if you plant nether wart everywhere, it is a great detail. I mean, just look at that. Just a nice little red plant there. You can do that as well. I even tried making some like mossy stone things. I don't know, I got a lot of work to do when it comes to detail. I'm nowhere near done. Like, what you see down here right now, it may look like a lot of detail, but this is nothing what I want it to look like. I'm wanting to add a lot more stuff around here. I want it to be rich with nature and detail. Oh yeah, and by the way, I'm using the default texture pack now, just because I didn't want to get too accustomed with the faithful, because I'm still trying to get used to default now, because I'm so used to faithful. yeah. Oh yeah, this place. Yeah, let's go ahead and farm it up a bit. I want to finish planting those seeds over there, if I have any, hopefully. Stay out of Dallas's crops. It is time to retire. Good old Expeditious. I've had this pick for a very long time. I've repaired it a lot of times. I guess we're going to find out. Do I not have a chest up here? Okay, well, this is it right here, Expeditious Mark 1. As you can see, it has, like, no health. I want to test if it is currently way too expensive. I do not want to spend around, like, 20 to 30 levels to fix one. So I guess we're going to find out real quick. That one, how much does it cost? Oh, whoa. What? Oh, that's a bug. I've repaired this pick at least 4 times already. Hey, I'm not complaining though. Huh. Well. Huh. I've already made the Expeditious 2 right here. Oh, no, which one's that? What? Oh, that's my fortune. All right, my Expeditious 2 is right here. Yeah, see, it's already almost used up. I haven't repaired this one yet, but... what? Now it's... No. Oh, I'm so confused right now. Oh, forget it. I made an Expeditious 2. And, well, I guess since... I'm just going to put you up there for now. Well, as you know, these are all my retired things right now. I meant to put Mark 1 on that. And soon when I create my actual armory, which is going to be real soon, my... Oh, my God, it's going to be the best armory you've ever seen in your life. not really, but I'm going to try my best. That's where I'm going to put all my, what is it? What's the word? I have a brain fart. What is it? Forget it. I don't care. Retired tools. That's what I was trying to say. Jesus, Dallas, what is wrong with you? I don't know. This Minecraft is getting to my head. In a good way, though. Spud, you're the only friend I have left. Please do not leave me. this is literally my only... I can't think of anything. No, I don't have anything. Anything at all. Well, let's run out to the horse stables real quick, and then we're going to build something that I've been wanting to build for a little while now. It's not really necessary, but then again, you guys know I like aesthetic stuff. Spud, I miss you, but you're too slow, man. Come on. Yeah, I still got to spice up this pathway, too. It's looking very... I don't know. Do you guys like it? Do you like the clean pathway look, or would you rather like rugged like I'm kind of doing now? Let me know. Any horses still in here? Oh my god, these are still in here? I thought they'd be all gone since I went on that big adventure. Why does an iron golem with a name tag on him despawn and a horse that doesn't even have a saddle or a name tag on him not despawn? That doesn't make any sense. And this horse, our first one, the glitched one that everyone was fighting in the comments saying it's a glitched mule and all that. Oh man. Alright, but let's go build this. What I'm wanting to build is a mini greenhouse. Of course, it's not going to have any use whatsoever. It's just going to be for looks. It's not going to have any plants that are farmable in it. I think I just want to put flowers in it. And it's going to be like the shape of one of these, but really small. And I think I want to put it right over here. I was thinking about putting it right here, but that would be kind of in the way of that. I think I want to put it right behind this brick wall on this little mound, and then you can see it peeking over a bit. So I think I want to, that would be really cool. Don't you think so, buddy? Yeah. What stuff did I have on you? This stuff would have despawned if he ever died. Oh, man. Huh. Have emeralds on him? And a freaking axe and a lot of hoppers? Maybe that's why he didn't despawn. The game realized, oh, he would be mad if he despawned. yeah, right here. I think I want to build it up here. This will be nice. And then I'm not going to try to build my base out behind these trees right here. I'm trying to make these trees look like the wall around my place. So, like, that's like a deep forest I don't want to go into. It's all dangerous with monsters. I don't know. I kind of like that feeling, being surrounded by my base. So let me go ahead and build this. You know what? I actually kind of like it. I know what you're thinking. Dallas, that is... What the heck is that? I know. It looks kind of like a two-year-old made it. But it matches my main greenhouse is there, kind of, in a very, very small way and very simple. But, you know, I kind of like it for some reason. It's just going to be up here for aesthetics. It's going to be really small. And what I wanted in here, obviously, is flowers. And we're going to do that in a second. But I can't decide what I want the roof to be. I got a bunch of glass. Do I want to do... No. That looks silly. Do I? Hey, it's working. I've been getting so much iron from that. Oh my god, look at all the little babies. Yeah, that... Oh, god, that'll look ugly. What am I doing? Oh, I need silk touch. Yeah, I'm going to experiment with the roof for a second. I don't want any wood up there. I wanted it to be like glass and clay. I'll take a look at it. Oh god. Oh god. That is the ugliest thing I've ever seen in my life. I have to come up with something else. I won't be able to live on this world knowing that this is over here. Hey, you know what? I actually kind of like that. Quartz looks all right. I think I've seen this somewhere before, someone using quartz for a greenhouse, and I thought I'd give it a try. This is all I had, though. This is all the quartz I have. That is weird. We never go to the Nether. We're going to have to do that next episode. I don't even have a portal set up anywhere, because the last time I was messing with portals was when we were trying to find a jungle biome, and I got them all messed up, and it was awful. But, yeah, I kind of like that. I'm trying to take a step back and look, because we'll be running past here a lot, and I'm just trying to see what it would look like. Yeah, I think that would look all right back there, to be honest. Just a nice little greenhouse up there. We'll create a pathway. Who knows, I might even think of something else in the future. I think I want to call this up here Creeper Forest. I know that's random, but I'm going to make this forest thicker and thicker in the future. Way thick. Like, I want it to go back probably another 30 to 50 blocks full of these trees, and even compact it even more, just make it really, really thick of them. Because every time, well, not because of, I just want to do that because I want to have a place surrounded by a big, like, pine forest. I like pine trees in real life, so. But I've killed so many creepers back here recently. It's just that I'm going to call it that. I don't know how I'm going to do it. I'm thinking I want to build, like, a big wall in front of the forest around my place. I think that'll look pretty cool. I've always wanted to build a big wall around my base. It's just, walls are hard to make, guys. They're not only hard to make, they're just the resources that you have to have a lot of, that whatever it is, just dang. Little Pete, how are you still here? This makes no sense. You don't even have a name tag on you. You're good. Oh wait, I'm gonna finish off my shovel. But yeah, I think I'm gonna go ahead and end it here. Well, we're gonna do the comment question of the day. I think I'll pick out a couple since I wasn't able to do that last few episodes. Any day now. My shovel can break. Any day. Holy crap, this is one strong shovel. There we go. Wow. Alright, let's go do it. Look at that. The wall's almost filled. Well, it basically is. I don't think I ever planned on doing any up there. I think I just planned on getting this one full and this one full, and then I'd move on to a new kind of thing, which I still have to do. Still haven't told you guys about my new idea. But we got two questions for today. First one comes from Roddy879. They ask, what is your favorite generated structure? My favorite, there's not a whole lot in Minecraft, but my new favorite one that I really like, because my favorite biomes are tundras. Like, well, they're not my favorite, but they're one of my favorites. If I got to build anywhere to choose for like a new world, I think I'd choose a tundra. If you don't know what that is, it's a plains biome with all snow, and all the oak trees are like pine trees, or spruce, you can say. And now there, if you didn't know, there's ice brain fart again. Why do I have so many brain farts? Those guys right there, those things. They have those generated structures now, and they are so cool because they have like a little layer down in them. Oh my gosh, igloos, that's what they're called. But my other favorite is Jungle Temple, which we still haven't found yet, and that is our next big adventure, is to find a jungle. I'll talk more about that later in the next few episodes, because I have a plan for stuff like that. But thank you for your question. Next one is from Jackster128. They ask, will I ever play any other games other than MCPE? Yeah, but not on this channel. If you did not know, my channel is Minecraft-based only. I mean, if my channel just happened to grow amazingly one day, which I doubt it will, but, like, if I had, I don't know how to say it, but if I had a lot of subscribers, we'll just say that, I would like to spread to other games, but I'd solely stick on Minecraft. But if I had to, I would probably pick, like, roleplay games, such as, like, maybe the Elder Scroll games, like, the single-player versions. I don't like the online stuff. I was always a fan of Skyrim. I like just roleplay games where you can create your own characters. That's why I play Minecraft. You get to create your own experience, do what you want, create your own world. So, yeah, I don't know. That's a good question, because it matters how the future unfolds. But yeah, that's gonna be it for today, guys. It took me a while to find some comments. I want you guys to go crazy down there. Comment. I want each and every one of you to comment like crazy. You right now. Comment four different questions. I want next episode, I'll pick like five comments. All right? Just go crazy down there, guys. I like seeing what you guys have to ask. So I'll see you guys in the next episode. Bye-bye.